This is the review for The Game Grid, the newest racing game out on Xbox One, PlayStation 4, and PC by Codemasters. I am not IGN or other review sites of that nature, nor do I want to be silly like Dunkey. Well, I would love to be funny like Dunkey, but no one should try to copy his style. He's amazing. I love you, Dunkey. Anyways, yes, Grid. Let's talk about the pros and cons of this game and break it down into a few sections to make this easier to chat about, shall we? Now, controls. This game feels good using the controller, and even though it feels like an arcade game, the game also feels heavy in its physics, and the cars seem to shift and work differently on rain and dry asphalt. The physics also get tricky on curbs using high-powered rear-wheel drive cars, around fast turns and other things that make you thankful for that rewind button. All in all, this game feels rather good on controller with stock settings. I also played this game, Grid, using the Thrustmaster TMX Pro wheel, and it feels solid. I wish there was more feedback on the pedals, and maybe a little bit more force feedback on the wheel, but overall, I liked the feel using the wheel. If you have the wheel, I highly suggest using it on Grid. If not, you aren't punished, as the controller feels equally as good. Definitely use the controller in chase cam and the wheel in cockpit cam. It just feels more natural. Now let's talk graphics. The graphics within Grid are both wonderful and shockingly bad at times. Racing around at night or in the rain or through a sunset looks truly amazing. Like, seriously, this game does look good. Then you can't help but notice how god-awful the rearview mirrors and rearview cameras look, with its low frames per second and choppy pixels. If you don't pay attention to that though, the game looks super, super sharp. I mean, it's not on the level of Forza Horizon 4, but it's very enjoyable. Nothing award-winning though. Sound. While I did mute the music, this review will be all about the car sounds. The sound design is great. I love hearing the exhaust notes and engine sounds while driving around a track. Hearing the turbo whine and tire screech is truly satisfying and really gets you in the game, especially if you're into the ambiance of racing, which I am. Everything from shifting gears to driving through puddles is simply wonderful to listen to. The attention to detail on sound is top-notch. Good job, audio team. Now, the gameplay on Grid is quite linear, as is most racing games. The game isn't as long as others, so achieving 100% completion isn't as daunting of a task as one may think. You can cheat the single-player game too, or just putting it on very easy and never qualify and win each race based off of how the reverse grid is set up, so you can easily win events that way. Or you can put it on very hard and go for using the go for the hot lap qualifying, which honestly I loved playing the game both ways. If you use the qualifying and go on very hard, it makes the game much more challenging and it plays completely different. Certain cars are tough to drive and some are easier to manage, which changing your traction control, stability, and anti-lock brakes really comes into play, and it makes that V8 supercar or the F1000 easier to drive. Grid can be challenging at times, especially when playing on very hard, as the qualifying pace of the AI is ungodly fast, but then they are a little slower during the race. This imbalance made things tricky, as the racing is usually 2 to 8 laps per race, depending on the type of car and track you're on, which usually means each race was about 3 to 8 minutes long, which isn't too bad. As fun as it is to race on these tracks, I really didn't find the gameplay to be awfully rewarding. Just enjoyable enough as I tried to race these cars around these tracks as fast as humanly possible and working towards completing an actual single-player career on a racing game. Multiplayer is on a whole nother level of gross, though. I will discuss that soon. I want to talk about some of the design used in Grid, namely the way single-player is played out on the track and its track designs. Grid's menus are easy to navigate, and I never felt lost or confused about where I needed to go or what I was doing. The use of hiring a teammate felt pointless, as it never really mattered. The AI are a bunch of bastards who love to swerve and pull off a smash move to send me into the Shadow Realm. Thank goodness Grid copied the Forza mechanic of press Y to rewind. The AI can also be really sensitive when it comes to getting mad and turning into a quote-unquote nemesis. Also, this Nemesis AI seems to drive a hell of a lot faster and with much more aggression as they try to block and defend and dive bomb and a whole bunch of other aggressive maneuvers and driving. The real tracks are nice, but the fake street courses and road courses are really what makes this game stand out. Whichever team worked on building these racetracks did a really, really great job, as I found these much more fun as, say, driving around Silverstone or Brands Hatch. Which seems like blasphemy, because those tracks are amazing, but this game really succeeds on the streets of San Francisco or Havana. Single player is literally a grid of linear races that doesn't feel too much like a grind, since all the races are super short. Sometimes these races are a little too short. A championship race feels anticlimactic when it's only two laps. I mean, these really, the end races per series just didn't feel like a nice championship race. It was kind of a letdown, but it was just nice to finish that series and move on to the next. I would like to see an endurance race or two put into the game. Hell, give me 100 laps of Crescent Valley in the GT1 class. That would be pretty fun. Speaking of fun, is grid fun? That is the most important thing when it comes to playing a game, and that's what each of these reviews will have after I talk about a couple of things. Is the game actually fun? So is grid fun? Yes. Grid is easily a fun game to play. I honestly looked forward to playing this game single player any chance I could before work, after work, before bed, in the middle of the night. I truly had a fun experience playing Grid's career mode. Most of the cars felt amazing, especially the TC2 and GT1 cars, and 95% of the tracks are a blast to drive around in. I read a lot of concern about the lack of tracks and how we have just different ribbons, reverse action, nighttime, and rain on these tracks, but I never felt like I was running the exact same track over and over and over and lapping these things non-stop. The way single player is set up, the racing never felt repetitive. The game's biggest mistake is its multiplayer, which they tried to patch today, but now I can't even load up the game, so hooray! I played in 10 lobbies of multiplayer in the past 2 or 3 weeks, and it's all set on Quick Match, which gives me a random lobby with random cars around random tracks. Now this is fine, this is fun, but don't make this my only option, and that's exactly what Grid does. Give me a chance to pick the cars I want to drive online. Now, for the racing itself, it's bugged and filled with AI. Yes, that's right. A multiplayer slash online game is filled with computer racers. I had maybe 2 good lobbies with 6 human players in them, but the rest was just me and one other person versus 14 AI who seemed to be even more filthy in an online lobby. Those guys were just punning me around the tracks and it was infuriating. I was looking forward to multiplayer more than anything due to it being a racing game, and these games are best online against others, but I can't even race against others at all. I may as well just concentrate on single player and at least progress through a game and beat it. Hopefully this patch fixes multiplayer, but at this time, the game is completely broken for me on Xbox and for all Xbox users. So as of right now, I'm going to give this game a 7 at best. Nothing truly groundbreaking when it comes to grid, but it's still fun to play as long as you stay away from multiplayer.